Conjola Park is still reeling after last month's bushfires, but today the tiny south coast town moved a step closer to recovery. Before the community can start the long process of rebuilding homes, it first has to tear them all down.
A new beginning. 7 long weeks in the making. Irony isn't lost on Kathy Bleicher.
Wow.
Who came to see her house get destroyed again.
Demolition derby, far out.
Her home is the very first in Conjola Park to be cleared through her own insurer with outsourced labour.
I think maybe there might be something there, mum's rings and all, you know, of course all the photos, everything's gone. So that's the reality of it, and that's the processing part. You've got to just take it in, accept.
Watching on, local Adam Wilson, who has his own excavator business with machines sitting idle.
We've got a community sitting on their backside at the moment. There's labour here ready to go.
Asbestos is front and centre of concerns.
Living in an environment that is known to be unsafe.
Questions fired in a heated community meeting. Lang O'Rourke announcing it will also take on the Conjola clean-up, part of a statewide $800 million job, expecting to get diggers into debris here within 3 weeks. Permanent residents get priority.
We need to assess each individual site. We need to ensure that the residents understand that we need to access their properties.
The bulk of the clean-up will be done by the government-appointed contractor, who says all these homes will be cleared by the end of June. West Nowra Landfill has been flagged to take the asbestos-contaminated waste, but it's a long road ahead. Kathy's home, just one of 89, lost on New Year's Eve. All will have to be demolished before they too can start again. Danielle Post, 9 News.